Hi everyone, this is Matt Metzger with Millborn Seeds, and we want to talk a little bit today about some of the nutritional concerns in annual forages and ways to manage around them so they don't become an issue on your operation. We're here in western South Dakota, just east of the Black Hills, so dry land scenario, and this is a warm season grazing mix that we're standing in, primarily dominated by sorghum sudangrass. And being grazed as we speak, there's cattle in front of me behind the camera, and it's early September now, so kind of a good time to be talking about some of these factors that could come into play here in the next couple weeks, because all of a sudden it's going to be fall. So I guess when you're talking about grazing anything that's got sorghum sudangrass or sudangrass in the name, there is the potential to have some prussic acid concern around the period of that first hard frost. And so just generally speaking, the safe bet is to avoid grazing right after that first hard frost and give it about a week. At that point, the plant's going to begin to, it'll be dead, it'll begin to dry down in the field, and that prussic acid will leave the plant through a natural process, and you're going to have safe forage to graze through the remainder of the fall and winter. As far as nitrates go, similar scenario, I guess. The other period to watch on those would be if you've got forage that's extremely drought stressed, and this can include cool season forages like oats as well. If they're really, really drought stressed to the point that that plant is stunted in its growth, there's the potential to be accumulating nitrates in that forage as well. So avoid grazing during those drought stress periods. And right after a drought ending rain, if that plant perks up and begins to actively grow, give it a little time beyond that, you know, about a week beyond that. And then that nitrate level will go down naturally in the plant as those nitrates convert to protein. And so you'll be safe to graze after that point. And that applies for really any grass type forage that's stunted by drought. And then the other period to watch, I guess, would be especially on warm season forages like we're in here with sorghum sedan. Be careful around the period of that. Like if you start getting light frosts that don't quite kill the plant, but they stunt the growth, then you can begin to accumulate nitrates as well. And so grazing, you know, during that kind of on and off period, what we'll be moving into in a couple weeks here, where we might start getting 31 degrees and those light frosts that just kind of nip these plants, but don't kill them. That's where you can begin getting some nitrate accumulation. So avoiding grazing during that period can be good. I guess as far as harvestable forage, if you're putting things up as dry hay, prussic acid really not much of a concern at all. The curing process where that forage is drying down into hay will remove that prussic acid from the plant. And so you're gonna have a safe hay bale to feed. And then the other one would be silage, in which case prussic acid also not really a concern. The fermentation process will essentially break down the prussic acid, and then when you remove that silage from the bunker or from the bag, the prussic acid will release as a gas, and so the actual feed will be safe to feed. And then if you're putting it up as dry hay, or I guess if we're talking nitrates, then would be the other one. And then putting it up as dry hay, nitrates will actually remain in the plant, so be careful there. Try not to hay drought stressed forage, try not to hay forage that just got nipped by a light frost and might be stunted. You could be getting some nitrate accumulation in that plant. I realize that a lot of times, especially in, you know, the Western US, sometimes we are haying forage because it's drought stress, you know, because a wheat crop failed and so we bale it up, and you will end up with some higher nitrate hay. In that scenario, I'd recommend testing the forage, see just how high your nitrates are, speak with your nutritionist, speak with us, and make a decision on, you know, what's safe to feed, what classes of livestock you can feed it to. Ultimately, a lot of those bales end up getting blended off and fed with lower nitrate forage. And then in siling, high nitrate forage. So if you're putting it up as silage, nitrate's really a non-factor. The ensiling process will break down nitrates to a safe level, and you'll be able to feed that to any class of livestock. So that's kind of a really quick crash course on a really big subject. And so if you got other questions or specific scenarios or concerns, certainly give us a call. We're happy to walk through them with you. Just like I said, this is the time of year where these things start coming into play, especially with warm season forages and that, you know, that early frost type deal. We're getting into that window already, and so it's time to be prepared for that. If you're actively grazing like we are here, it's time to watch the temperatures at night. And if you start getting to that point where it looks like we're going to freeze hard, probably get these cattle out of here. We got a hillside with grass on it right behind us, and certainly go there for a week and then come back in here and finish grazing this out through the fall and winter. So like I said, big subject, but kind of a quick crash course. If you have other questions or specific scenarios, let us know. Give us a call. We're happy to help. Once again, this is Matt Metzger with Millborn Seeds, and thanks for watching.